आदरणीय कुलपति प्रोफेसर अजमेर सिंह मालिक जी, प्रोफेसर राजेंद्र कुमार जी कुलपति दीनबंधु छोटू राम विश्वविद्यालय मुरतल सोनीपत, पूर्व छात्र एसोसिएशन के निर्देशक श्री सुरेंद्र कुंडू जी, पूर्व छात्र सम्मेलन से जुड़े सभी पूर्व छात्र शिक्षाविदी प्रोफेसर साहिबान व प्रिय छात्रों, सबसे पहले मैं पूर्व छात्र सम्मेलन आयोजित करने पर चौधरी देवीलाल विश्वविद्यालय सिरसा के कुलपति प्रोफेसर अजमेर सिंह मालिक एवं उनकी पूरी टीम को हार्दिक बधाई और शुभकामनाएं देता हूँ। साथ ही साथ सभी पूर्व छात्र जो इस सम्मेलन से जुड़े हैं उनका स्वागत करता हूँ। उन्हें इस बात की बधाई देता हूँ कि आपका प्यार व स्नेह अपने विश्वविद्यालय से बना हुआ है। पूर्व छात्र व वर्तमान छात्र किसी भी विश्वविद्यालय व शिक्षण संस्था की धरोहर व पूंजी होते हैं। पूर्व छात्र संस्थान व विश्वविद्यालय के विकास में महत्वपूर्ण योगदान देने के साथ साथ वर्तमान में पढ़ रहे छात्रों को शिक्षा से संबंधित बेहतर सुविधाएं उपलब्ध करवा सकते हैं। मुझे यह कहते हुए खुशी हो रही है कि नई राष्ट्रीय शिक्षा नीति 2020 में मूल्य आधारित शिक्षा, कौशल व व्यावसायिक शिक्षा तथा बच्चों के समग्र विकास पर फोकस किया गया है। बच्चों को प्राइमरी व उच्च शिक्षा से ही उनकी रुचि अनुसार कौशल शिक्षा प्रदान करने की शुरुआत हुई है, जिसमें ये बच्चे बड़े होकर नौकरी ढूंढने वाले ही नहीं बल्कि नौकरी देने वाले बने। मुझे यह कहते हुए गर्व हो रहा है कि 70 साल में पहली बार प्रधानमंत्री श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी के नेतृत्व में तैयार की गई राष्ट्रीय शिक्षा नीति में स्थानीय मांग के आधार पर शैक्षणिक ढांचा तैयार करने का, युवाओं को कौशल बनाने का प्रावधान किया गया है। सभी विश्वविद्यालय इसी अनुरूप व्यवस्था करें। विश्वविद्यालयों का मुख्य उद्देश्य होना चाहिए कि वे ज्ञान के पारंपरिक और उभरते क्षेत्रों में उच्च शिक्षा, शोध, अनुसंधान और व्यावसायिक कोर्सों को बढ़ावा देना है। इस एलुमनी मीट में जुड़ने के लिए 800 से भी अधिक पूर्व छात्रों ने पंजीकरण करवाया है। ये सभी छात्र विभिन्न ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म यानी गूगल मीट और यूट्यूब का उपयोग कर पूर्व छात्र सम्मेलन से जुड़ रहे हैं। मैं विश्वविद्यालय के पूर्व छात्रों से अपील करता हूँ कि विश्वविद्यालय को आत्मनिर्भर बनाने के लिए आगे आए। अंत में एक बार फिर मैं सभी पूर्व छात्रों को सम्मेलन से जुड़ने पर और विश्वविद्यालय की पूरी टीम को सम्मेलन आयोजित करने की बधाई देता हूँ। जय हिंद, जय हरियाणा।
मोस्ट रेस्पेक्टेड एंड ऑनरेबल चांसलर गवर्नर ऑफ चौधरी देवीलाल यूनिवर्सिटी श्री बंडारू दत्तात्रेय जी एंड आवर एफर्वेसेंट एक्टिव वाइस चांसलर साहब प्रोफेसर अजमेर सिंह मालिक जी प्लस ऑल यू कोलीग्स, आई एम डॉक्टर कुंडू एंड द एंटायर टीम हु आर ए पार्ट ऑफ दिस इम्पॉर्टेंट प्रोग्राम एंड नॉट द लीस्ट द एलुमनी हु हैव ऑलरेडी जॉइंट इन दिस प्रोग्राम। आई बिलीव सक्सेस ऑफ एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और द नेम ऑफ एनी organization is just because of the alumni. I'm not just talking about academics alone, but any other training center, the name of the center become a part of the history only because of alumni. Today we know about Sandeepani Ashram. It's not because of Muni Sandeepani alone. It is only because we had a student like Lord Krishna there, or maybe Sudhama. These are the reasons. Take the case of Harvard, take the case of Cambridge, take the case of any other big organizations. All of them have become what they are is only because of their alumni. One sloka which is coming to my mind is from the Veda, which all of us know, which tells each one of us, like, once we come together and once we work together, how that unity can be progressed as a organizational benefit and upliftment. This is not just for individual but for the entire organization. Sangachadvam sambadadvam sambho manamsi janatam devabhagam yadha purve sanjanana upasate samano mantrasamiti samani samanam manasahachittamesham samanam mantramabhimantrayeva samanenavu havishajuhomi samaniva akutiha samana hridayaniva samanamastu mano yathava susahasiti sangachadvam sambadadvam sambho manamsi janatam. Its abstract meaning is like, let us all be together, let us all think in the same way, let us all work together. That's the only way we together can progress. In fact, this is what our Governor Saab was trying to tell us also, how to bring Atmanirbharada, I mean the resilience in whatever we do in our education. And interestingly, the modern new education policy 2020 is giving us all these opportunities. So the modern education arena will be like a supermarket where you go and buy whatever you want. And NEP 2020 has given you an ABC model, Academic Bank for Credit. This ABC will help you to put all your credentials, credits, whatever you are earning at some point of time. For example, you just imagine, suppose a singer like Lata Mangeshkar ji, if she were little poor in mathematics, I'm sure she won't be able to make a pass in 10th class. But can we imagine any one of us, the world's best mathematician, can he sing a single song in which how beautifully she rendered it and how the gamagams are reproduced in 100 years of training? We can't do that. So the ability or the efficiency of an individual, it cannot be decided by just forcing some specific subjects that you should do it. So all those days are gone. Now the new generation kids have all this freedom. So they can, even when they do a graduation in economics, if he is good in acting, he can even opt a course in acting, another course in singing. And by chance, if you need to move from one part of the country to the other part of the country, nothing to worry about it, because you have an ABC which is owned by you. Your bank account is yours. I mean, the academic credit bank is yours. You put your credits there, And 3 years you want to work, okay, you take a break, come back again, do a couple of courses, add some more credits. The moment you cross 60 or something, you get a postgraduate diploma. After some time, once you complete a graduation, once you complete 120 courses, you will get a plain graduation. Or if you complete exactly as per what is prescribed in a specific course, you will get a specific degree in maybe in mathematics or economics or social sciences. What I believe is the role of alumni is very, very, very high. So this kind of meetings and platforms will help all of us to come together, like what I said in the beginning of the Vedic mantra, the same way we all have to get together and progress together and make our alma mater the best in the country or best in the world. So this is an wonderful initiation. I just want to thank Professor Ajmer Singh Ji for inviting me also to be a part of this great program, and I wish all the success and thanks to each alumni, because I'm also a VC of another university. Doesn't make a difference whether I'm from CDLU or TCRES, doesn't make a difference. Every alumni is an alumni. We are all thankful to you for joining in this program today and making it a big success. Thank you so much and God bless.
The university or the place at Sirsa, we are having a very calm kind of environment. Society is very much civilized, not aggressive. Soft-spoken people are here. And that's why we say that I'm a firm belief that this university has the potential to become more and more big one. And it is likely to be a bigger university. And Professor Anayatji, I hope that this university will be in the club of the prestigious university of this state, like your university. Some of you may know about it that I joined last December in this university. And really, I'm happy to share with you that the people working here, they are really wanted to build up this university. They are coming forward, taking initiative, asking me to lead so that we can become a university of prominence in this particularly north part of the country. So please create a perception about this university, positive perceptions. Try to make it known to all those who matters to us, who can help us, who can network with us, who can take along with, who can take us along with them, so that we can become a part of the mainstream of the society, particularly in the education field. So please create that kind of the perceptions about us, about your university, about yourself. And please support the students who have been pursuing education here in this university by guiding them, by mentoring them for employment, not only for employment, but also in setting up the ventures, particularly the, nowadays we call it the startup, something like that one, that will make this university much bigger. And we must strive, we must pledge for that this university, this is our university, let's make it bigger and bigger. Thank you very much again for all, particularly the most respectful Honorable Governor Chancellor and Professor Rajendra Anayatji for providing us the time and to bless us by their presence. And we are feeling proud of it and feeling motivated by your participation in this program. Thank you very much.